Lenny Rolls, who ultimately recommended that route, was there by Institute John Eastman, and hence he argues was representing Trump's ask. Trump ultimately asked to voting to be paused and for the votes to be sent back to the states to be confirmed by the delegates there. So that's ultimately what Trump's argument would be, and you would say there's nothing inherently unconstitutional about that request, Alicia.
Yeah, and Trump has already pointed out that the potential for bias in this case is there because of the judge, the location. He's hoping for a change of venue. What's next?
Well, another example of that, Judge Tanya Shefkin, she referred to Trump as Mr. Trump, not President Trump, not former President Trump, but Mr. Trump. By comparison, U.S. District Judge in Florida, Eileen Cannon, referred to him as former President Donald Trump. And you have to ask yourself, Alicia, do you think any other former president would be referred to as Mr. in a court of law? No, it's Trump. So that's another example of how this may be an unfair judge and an unfair venue, Alicia. So they're obviously going to try to move this to a more purple region, such as West Virginia or the middle of Virginia, but there is not a precedent for a January 6th case getting moved to a different venue. Judges here in the district have rejected that, saying that through jury selection, they would be able to negate the fact that this is a 93% jury pool.
Make America great again.
That's argument. Because it's so heavily slanted left, jury pool selection is not enough
USA,
to make it an unfair
USA,
venue.
USA,
so it's highly unlikely that President Trump's request will ultimately be granted. But
make America great again.
It's certainly a valid
stepping
request,
out of the
in my opinion,
limo now,
the
President Donald J. Trump. Number 47.
All right, Daniel, we're getting a live look at Donald Trump right now. It looks like he's walking out of his motorcade, maybe possibly
number 47.
Speaking with supporters. Do we have his microphone for this?
Seeing the filth and the decay and all of the broken buildings and walls and the graffiti, this is not the place that I left. It's a very sad thing to see it. When you look at what's happening, this is a persecution of a political opponent. This was never supposed to happen in America. This is the persecution of the person that's leading by very, very substantial numbers in the Republican primary and leading Biden by a lot. So if you can't beat him,
you
persecute him or you prosecute him. We can't let this happen in America. Thank you very much.
Everybody. God bless you. That was President Trump, number 47, that will be in 2025, January the 1st at 7 o'clock a.m.
Reporters and people standing outside.
It will be voted in.
He said, this whole case is persecution of a political opponent.